Welcome back, everybody. Thank you for joining me for another adventure right here on Intrepid World. Today, I'm going to be bringing you along with me as I show you all the Cape Legrand Coastal Trail. But this isn't where my journey began. So after my quick intro, which tells you a little bit about me and what I do here on YouTube, I will take you all with me back to the beginning.
G'day, mate. My name is Ollie, and I absolutely love the great outdoors. I go scuba diving, hiking and camping, care for two rescued dingoes, and travel the world looking for new places to explore and even get to make new friends along the way. If you like this kind of content, please like and subscribe, because I would absolutely love for you to join me on my adventures right here on Intrepid World. I started my hike from the Legrand Beach end of the Cape Legrand Trail. I left nice and early so I could enjoy the sunrise over Cape Legrand National Park. Been raining for the last few days. All the water's gathered together to film this little tiny stream, which is pretty cool. But it comes down the granite rock face.
Absolutely stunning out here this morning. Oh wow.
Love it.
There's also a bunch of caves up there. How cool is that?
During the early morning light, the caves at the top of these hills looked absolutely stunning.
Just been following the markers, but I just want to point this out. A lot of this walk is actually over granite, and it was raining the last few days, so even though it's beautiful and sunny today, there's actually a lot of water coming down off the mountains, and this black stuff is super slippery. It's like being on ice, so you have to watch your step. It's a little bit slow going through here, a little bit technical, and I have actually fallen over a few times already. It is still pretty slippery along here, so just mind your step. Check it out. That's Hellfire Bay. That's where I'm heading right now. Beautiful. What a view. This section from Legrand Beach through to Hellfire Bay certainly is not lacking a sense of adventure. You can see here big boulders and things that I have to jump across on this creek, and the entire way has been quite rocky and, as I mentioned before, quite slippery because of these black sections. Some of them catch you out. You think you're going to be okay, you put your foot down and then you just slip over. I've slipped over about 7 times, I think. It's crazy. I just came down that trail. Look at that view. That's incredible. Have you ever seen anything like that in your life? Those colors are not edited. That is legit exactly how it looks. Oh my goodness. It might not look it, but this descent was actually quite steep and slippery, which turned out to be a pretty common theme throughout this video.
Despite the difficulty walking on slippery surfaces, I would 100% do this hike again because I love the adventure and I love visiting all of these incredible locations.
Looks like I've made it to Thistle Cove. I think the Le Grand Beach through to Thistle Cove section of this hike was definitely the hardest. Just looking at what I have to do from this point on, I have to get over to that point there. I think what I've just been through is the most difficult section. So I'm looking forward to picking up the pace a little bit from here on out, not having to scramble over as many rocks anymore. Let's do it. I've made it to Thistle Cove. Look at this beach. Absolutely stunning.
Pristine white sand, turquoise blue water.
What a ripper. Just made it to the inlet crossing.
I can pretty much just go over on these stones there.
Bye, Thistle Cove.
What a view.
I visited Cape Le Grand National Park over the first weekend in August and had beautiful spring-like weather. There were a few showers, hence why I was walking on slippery granite surfaces on occasion, but practically had this place to myself. If I saw 40 other people in the national park, that would have been about it. On the Cape Le Grand Coastal Trail, I only passed 3 other people, but pretty much got to explore this entire place by myself, which was absolutely fantastic.
Interesting point to make. See all the bees?
There are signs around about the place saying that if you have allergies to bee stings, then you need to take extra care when you're on this trail because there are lots of wild beehives along the trail. So make sure you take an EpiPen or something like that if you are allergic to bees. Lucky Bay. What an absolutely beautiful location. So the town of Esperance, Cape Le Grand National Park and Lucky Bay all have a very interesting story on how they acquired their names. You see, a very long time ago there was a ship named the El Esperance that was cruising down the West Australian coastline when it ran into a major storm. And a brave young sailor by the name of Le Grand climbed the tallest mast on the ship so that he could try and spot safe harbour. And this is the area that he found. So once the ship pulled into this area, the captain named it Lucky Bay, because if they had not been able to find this safe harbour, the ship and its crew surely would have perished. And because of his bravery, Le Grand now has a national park named after him. You might have already seen that I did the Cape to Cape track. The beaches along the Cape to Cape track were a little bit boggy, but this track, all the beaches have been smooth and compact and really easy to walk on.
I did do some research about the area before I came down here, but seem to have got my facts a little bit mixed up. Although my recount of the El Esperance and Officer Le Grand climbing the tallest mast on the ship was accurate, Lucky Bay was actually named by English Sea Captain Matthew Flinders in 1802 as he circumnavigated Australia. They found themselves facing very similar perils at sea as the crew of the El Esperance, and they pulled into that safe harbour. He then named it Lucky Bay, because if they had not found that spot to take shelter, then him and his crew surely would have perished.
This is quite narrow. Check this out. This is a little overgrown. Oh man, face full of flowers. Not a bad thing, they smell fantastic. The wildflowers in this section are amazing, they're everywhere. And the birds are absolutely loving them. Down into a ditch.
The end is in sight. This hike took me a lot longer than I anticipated, especially that first section. It was so slippery. Yeah, so my legs were super tired by the time I got through the first two sections, but then after Thistle Cove, it got a lot better.
And yeah, I've just really enjoyed this hike. It was definitely a challenge, and I wouldn't recommend anyone to hike it after it's been raining for a few days,
because that's why everything was so slippery and difficult to walk on.
But we're getting there, almost done.
Well, after 8 hours of hiking and filming this YouTube content, I can say I am very proud to have completed the Cape Le Grand Coastal Trail. Visiting the town of Esperance and completing this hike in the Cape Le Grand National Park has been on my bucket list for a very long time. And I'm not going to sugarcoat it, that was probably one of the hardest hikes I've ever done. Mainly because right at the start, going over those granite hills, because of the rain over the previous 2 days, it was very slippery. It was like walking on ice, so it was quite technical. I had to be pretty careful where I was placing my feet. And I did fall over several times, so it was quite challenging to begin with, probably for the first 10 kilometers actually, and then the last 10 kilometers was pretty easy going. So yeah, I am really thrilled to have completed that hike. Thistle Cove is beautiful, Hellfire Bay is absolutely stunning, and Lucky Bay is spectacular. So for those of you who are mad keen on hiking, and for those of you that are willing to give it a go, I would highly recommend that you come and do the Cape Le Grand Coastal Trail. It was absolutely spectacular. I loved every minute of it. And as always, enjoy life, have a great time, go have an adventure. See ya. Now I just have to walk back to my car, but I'm not going that way. I'm gonna go along the road. It's gonna take me a few hours to get back to my car. Ah, well.